In this video, a control that you might know from a very popular dating app, and you can now add that inside of your .NET MAUI application yourself. Which one? Let's go have a look. Of course, I'm talking about Tinder, the very popular dating app that everyone knows about, but no one has ever really used it. So weird. But Tinder has this very cool control, which is kind of like a stack of cards, and you can swipe right to like the person, or left to kind of like dismiss them, or the other way around, because obviously I've never used the app. But it's a very cool concept. You can make that very easily and apply that to other apps to kind of like make a selection about things. And that's a project that I've used it for with Xamarin.Forms, and I want to use that again on a new project, on a revival of that project. More on that later, little teaser right here. But this swipe card view, as it was called for Xamarin.Forms, has not been ported to .NET MAUI yet. The author may be moved on to other things, I don't know, but it has been like 4 years since the last commit, and I was like, okay, I want to use this project right here, I want to use this library, but now for .NET MAUI, so I'm going to migrate it to .NET MAUI, and it was super easy to do, because it used only Xamarin.Forms components, which are now .NET MAUI components, so basically the only thing I had to do was update the references from Xamarin.Forms to .NET MAUI, rename a couple of namespaces, and it worked. So super easy migration, super cool. So I did that, made it into a library, and now not just I can use it, but you can use it as well. So let's just hop over to my screen share and let me show you how to implement this in your own .NET MAUI application. Here in Visual Studio 2022, I created a new MAUI project, as I typically do in my videos. I added one thing though, which is a monkey model, so you don't have to watch me type the boring stuff right here. So here I have this monkey.cs, and it uses like system.text.json serialization to kind of like get a monkey model with name, location, details. I'm not going to use all of that, and a serializer, etc., etc. Not something that you should worry about. You can replace this with your own models that you want to use for the cards that we're actually showing. So we're going to have a look in this in a second. I'm not going to explain like in full detail what's going on here. If you want to know more about all of this stuff right here, let me know down in the comments below as always. So what's the important thing here is the other thing, the swipe card view. So I'm going to first install the library. So let's go over to our solution explorer, and I'm going to right click our project right here, and I'm going to do manage NuGet packages, and then I'm going to search for plugin.maui.swipeCardView. Plugin.maui is a concept that I've done in another video, find it down below linked, which is a kind of like repository, template repository that you can use to create your own plugins. So if that's something that you're interested in, go check out that video as well. But here I've used it for this swipe card view migration to .NET MAUI. You can see preview 1, so make sure to check this include pre-release checkbox right here so that it shows up. Maybe by the time you're watching this, there is a new version out already, or maybe it's stable already, but I like to do it in preview first so that you can test it out a little bit and see what's going on. And we can just install this on our project. So let's do that. Installing this thing right here. You have to review the license, obviously. I accept, so let's do that. I've read it because I wrote it, right? So I've installed it now on my project, and you can see no dependencies, right? Because it uses only .NET MAUI elements. It's built up out of .NET MAUI elements, and .NET MAUI will do all the translation to the native counterparts on each platform. So that's really, really cool. And a very easy way to kind of like make composite controls for .NET MAUI. Okay, we've got it installed. There's one thing you need to do in the MAUI program still to kind of like initialize this. I hope I can get rid of that in a later version, but for now, this is needed. So go to your Solution Explorer again and into your MAUI program. And what you need to do here for the MAUI app builder is .use swipe card view. And whenever you do that, I think IntelliSense will kind of like kick in and say, hey, you need a using statement for this. Using plugin.maui.swipeCardView, it will add that here at the top, and you should be good to go. Now, the only thing that this does under the hood is do .use MAUI compatibility. Because there is one element inside of this package, which is the relative layout, I think, which uses the MAUI compatibility layer. I want to get rid of that, but I haven't been able to do that yet, just because I didn't find the time to do it. So the only thing to kind of like do that is use SwipeCardView, and under the hood, it will enable that compatibility thing for you. Nothing to worry about, just add this line and you should be good to go. Okay, so we got that. Now we can actually start implementing it. So as we do with XAML, obviously everything you can do in XAML, you can do in C Sharp, but I love my XAML. So I'm just gonna do here XML NS in the top swipe is swipe card view. I'm just gonna let IntelliSense help me here, plugin.SwipeCardView, et cetera, et cetera. So make sure that you add this line, which is basically adding a using statement, but now in XAML. Now I can remove basically this whole thing, the whole scroll view. I don't want that. I guess adding a scroll view into this is a bit weird because then the swipe doesn't really know where to go where, right? So that might not be the best idea, but you can definitely do it in kind of like a stack layout so that you can wrap all kinds of other controls around it. We'll see that in a minute when I pull up the sample app for this project, but I'm going to show you how to implement this yourself first. And now you can do swipe, and we have just one control, swipe card view. There we go. We implemented the swipe card view. Bam, that's it. But of course, it might be nice to actually show something on it, right? So, and kind of like this is a specialized version of the collection view, of the list view, of the carousel view. So it has all these things here too. It has the item source. It has an item template. It can tell you what the top item is that is shown right now. So it has all these kind of like properties that you can use, the animation length, the back card scale. So whenever the card that you can see in the back, whenever you start swiping something, what scale that might have, all these kinds of things that you can influence with the properties right here. From the original project, there is a lot of documentation included about the APIs. So I took that into my fork. Thank you so much. I think your name was Marco, the original author and the contributors, of course. Thank you so much for doing all that. I can just take that one-on-one because there has been no changes to the APIs yet. So just read that documentation on the repository. And while you're there on the repository, make sure to star it as well. Very important, star repositories that you like. Okay, so we got that. Now, let me make this not self-closing because we need a item template later too. And we want to use the item source at the very minimum, right? And to do that, I'm gonna use these monkeys. So let's go to my main page code behind right here through the Solution Explorer, click the mainpage.xaml.cs, and I'm going to implement some code here. Actually, I'm first going to remove this counter clicked because we don't have that, and then this count field, don't need that as well. And what I am going to add is do prop, which is a snippet, right? Prop, tab, and then you can, you know, you get this snippet for a property. And I'm going to do an observable collection so that it updates nicely of the monkey model right here. So now I have an observable collection of monkeys. Let's call it monkeys 2. There we go. And let's initialize it here too, right? So let's initialize it like that. And this is kind of like the shorthand notation, so I don't have to type new observable collection monkey, right? It knows that automatically. So I have this, which is cool, but now we need to populate it also with the actual monkeys, right? So let's do that in the override here on navigated 2, which is a good place to kind of like start populating your data. And the reason I'm doing it here is because I can do async and await here instead of like, you know, trying to async this constructor, which is something that is not possible. So actually, let me bring in some code so you don't have to watch me type here all the time. Let me just do that here from off screen. Actually, monkeys.clear is a good idea. I don't have that. Let's do monkeys.clear first so that we, you know, have a clean collection, although we're navigating to, so probably everything is destroyed, but this is like good practice, right? So we're going to clear the collection first, so we are sure that there's no monkeys in the collection right now. And what I'm going to do then is get a response through a new HTTP client. Now, you probably don't want to create a new HTTP client all the time like I'm doing here. Actually, I'm not going to show you this not great code here. Let's not do that. I'm going to do this. I'm just going to do that once. So I'm going to have this private HTTP client. HTTP client, that's fine. Let's just create a new one once, right? So I'm not gonna teach you anything bad right here. And actually, let's just be consistent and do this one like that too. Okay, and now I'm gonna say, hey, I'm gonna use this HTTP client, right? Okay, that's much, much better. Await HTTP client, get async, and for my good friend, see, I'm getting all excited right here. For my good friend, James Montemagno, I have this URL which hosts a monkey JSON. He uses that sample data everywhere. So I have this little monkeys JSON, which is just a JSON feed with, like, I don't know, 10 monkeys in there with an image, with a name, with a couple of things right here. So I'm just going to borrow that. And whenever the response is a success code, so it's like an HTTP 200, I'm going to go ahead and actually maybe move the clear here so that we don't clear it and we end up without any data. So whenever we know we get new data, then we're going to clear the monkeys and we're going to get the result monkeys from here from the response.content, right? So we get an HTTP response back with the content of that JSON data. And then we're going to read from JSON async and we're going to say, hey, this monkey context, which is the thing that you saw here, right? This monkey context, don't worry about it, is a little bit of advanced JSON stuff right here. Don't worry about it. It kind of like extracts the metadata from our monkey and from the JSON file. And it's going to deserialize it that way. And if our result monkeys is not null, right, if there's data there, then we're going to loop through it and add the monkey to our little monkeys observable collection. And you want to not do new observable collection here and add all the monkeys that way, because that will break your data binding. Again, if there's something here that you want to know more about, let me know down in the comments. Okay, the last thing we need to do is set the binding context, else I'm not going to see anything, to this, right? So this means, like, hey, for the binding context of this main page, whenever I refer in my XAML to, hey, binding monkeys, which I will do in a second, it's going to look at this, so at the main page, to actually get that property, right? So that's how data binding works. So, okay, it's going to get the monkeys. Now it's time to wire up the XAML. So let's go to my XAML page, and I'm going to say here, binding monkeys, right? Monkeys, there we go. So this now refers to binding monkeys, refers to this property right here, because I set the binding context to this. And because I'm kind of like populating it here, this will automatically get populated, this will automatically get data, and it will show my monkeys. That is, if I set a nice item template. So do item template, whoops, I need to do, of course, SwipeCardView.ItemTemplate. And with the item template, like the collection view and the list view, etc., etc., you can set a item template that is applied to each item, right? To each monkey in my monkey collection. So what I'm going to do here is do a data template, which we need right here. And then we actually, let me copy a little bit from this here as well, so you don't have to, again, watch me type all the things. And I can just explain it. I'll put in a grid right here. And I'm using a grid so that I can overlap these two things. So an image and a label. You can use any layout in here that you want. But here I'm going to say, hey, image.source is going to be image. And this suddenly refers to the monkeys, right? So inside of a data template, you're looking at one object, at one monkey object. So one object out of this collection right here. And here for this monkey, we have this image, which is a string. And I'm going to assume that this is a valid URL, et cetera, et cetera, things to take into account in a real world app. But for this sample code, I'm just going to assume that these are all correct, which they are. So I'm going to do that source image. I'm going to set aspect fill so that the whole card is kind of like filled. And then for a label, I'm going to set the binding name. Again, that's a property on the monkey. Set it to white so we're sure that we can actually see it. Set it to large, and I'm going to put it in the center, right, so that we can really see it right there. So this template is going to be used for all of our monkeys in our collection. And actually, let's start running this on Android. I have the emulator running already, so it will now start building my project, deploy that to my Android emulator, and we should see kind of like a stack of cards of monkeys, and I can swipe through that like Tinder and select our favorite monkey. Okay, so our build has completed. It is deploying to my Android emulator, as I just said. So here we are, our app is coming up. But for this case, we should see an actual, like, very poorly styled stack of cards. And actually, while this is running, we can use hot reload. You can see it right here, right? We have the first monkey is loaded here, and you can see I can start swiping it, right? So you can see it swipes left and right. And it doesn't really look great because it's now like super full screen. So let's add a little bit of padding right here of like, I don't know, 30, something like that. And you can see through hot reload, now the padding gets applied, right? Woo, hot reload works too. I don't need to stop my application, just boom, padding, and here we go. This is a baboon, you can see that, and I can swipe it to the right. I love the baboon. And now we have the capuch, which is great too. And here you can see kind of like that scale property come in play, right? Like the next card is being loaded. I don't know why I did it for the previous one. I think it has to do with the way I load the data maybe. Or there's still a little bug in there. It's a preview library. And you can see the next monkey coming up and you can see that scale going, right? So you can see, hey, there is a card behind this and I can swipe it up to, or I can swipe it to the right, or I can swipe it to the down. And that's all stuff that you can influence as well. Again, through hot reload, if I do here, I think it's called swipe, supported swipe directions. And you can kind of like list it with commas. So I want to do it only left and left and right. So the supported swipe directions are left and right. And I think through hot reload that works. So if I now swipe it up, it will do it, but it will pop back, right? It doesn't trigger anything. And I think there's also events and commands that will tell you like, hey, is it swipe left or right? So you can implement your business logic with, hey, what should happen now with this swipe action, right? But I can still do it kind of like left, see, then it disappears. And I can do it right and that still works. And I can still also kind of like turn it around. I can say, hey, I only want to make this to the bottom. So now basically everything I do, well, I think hot reload didn't take this, but you should be able to kind of like now do it left or right. And it doesn't really take, but it only kind of like does it to the bottom. Is it, oh, it's probably not bottom. It's probably down, right? Okay, down. So that's why it didn't take. So if I do this now, it won't go right, left, no, right, no, only down. Right? So that works too. And I think you can even like restrict like that. It doesn't even move to the left and the right, if that's what you want. Right? So this is how easy it is to get started with implementing this swipe view inside of your own .NET MAUI application. Now, let's quickly switch over to that sample app. I deployed it earlier to my emulator right here. And it's very, very simple. We have a simple page where you can have like, hey, a very simple card view. And you can say, hey, loop yes or no. So that's another thing. You can say, hey, I want to loop it yes or no. I think there's 5 items in here. So you can see 1, 2, 3, and you can see even a label down to the bottom here. And you can see that it got swiped to the left and the right. See, that's all stuff that we can detect. And boom, now it's gone. And if you don't do the loop, it will run out of cards at some point. Or you can say, hey, I want to loop it and add another 5 cards. And I can say, hey, go left, right, and it will come back to 1, right? So you can see that it loops kind of like as the carousel view where you can loop through the whole thing over and over and over again. So very simple view. Then we have this Tinder page right here, which is again, very styled to how Tinder looks like, right? So we can swipe from right here, but we can also use the button. So you can also programmatically trigger it. And you can see that it also has a little cool effect with like, hey, if I click the heart right here, you can see that it says liked here in the top, right? So you can see like, yes, or you can see nope right here very quickly, or you can say, hey, super like. So you can also apply all these kind of cool animations with what's going on here whenever someone swipes. And then we have this customizable page where you have like all the options, or at least a lot of the options. And you can say, hey, supported dragging directions, left and right, no. See, but now you can not even actually swipe it left and right, and it will only respond to kind of like top and bottom, right? And you can do it with the other sides as well. So it doesn't really go to the top or the bottom, but only kind of like left and right. So it really blocks the other animations that are going on right here. And the supported swipe directions, right? Like I said, like I showed you earlier, that it will actually pop back whenever it's not a supported swipe direction. So this is a dragging direction. This is the swipe direction. Then you have the threshold of like, hey, how much does a person need to swipe to actually take it, right? That's something that you kind of like need to tweak maybe. I think there's a default setting which works for most cases, but you can very much tweak like, hey, there's a threshold of like, I want to swipe this only a little bit, or I have to swipe this like really hard to actually be able to take. The loop cards, you can play with the animation length. You can play with the rotation, right? So we can set the rotation to like super much. And then you can see like, hey, whenever I start swiping, it kind of like rotates the whole card out of here. It's a bit hard to see because all the colors are the same. But it kind of like rotates out of there. So all this cool stuff available in this new library, SwipeCardView for .NET MAUI, this is how to use it. Now, I think this is really amazing, but I'm curious to hear your thoughts, so let me know down in the comments. And I might be biased, of course, a little bit, but I only ported this library to .NET MAUI, so thank you so much, Marco and contributors, for the original library in Xamarin.Forms. Let me know if you're using this in any of your projects. Like this video, start a repository, and I'll be seeing you for my next video, which might just as well be this one. See you there.